Podcast 17. Will set.
Awaken the leader inside. Follow the path of leadership. Never give up. Never stop trying. Get up. Believe in yourself. Not every day is going to be easy, but you've got to challenge yourself. You need courage. Be ready. Stop waiting for it to happen. Go make it happen. Harness the power within. You were destined to be a leader. Follow the path of leadership. Awaken the leader inside.
Podcast 17. Will set.
Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Dave Rubalcava and I'm your host here at Awaken the Leader Inside. Thank you guys for joining us in another episode. And if this is your first time, I just want to let you know I appreciate you guys tuning in. We are on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, and now we're on YouTube as well. I just recently loaded up the episodes so that you guys can hear them there as well. You know what? Today we're going to talk about will set. And we've mentioned will set kind of throughout all of the podcast at some point. Will set is going to factor into your career. And so we've gone through the seven values of leadership so that at least you have some general knowledge about what they're about. But now I really want to talk about how to apply them. And I'm going through a situation right now personally that I'm managing two different stores at the same time. You know, I'm covering another store as well as running my own. And, you know, I've come to realize that there's a big difference in these two stores when it comes to will set. And will set is a powerful tool because you're going to need that when you're changing cultures. But I wanted to share these two situations that are going on and what I've learned from them and how I was able to connect with these leaders in multiple buildings and assess something different, even though the end result is that the execution is not happening. But these two situations have two different needs. And I think that's what's important to understand when we're talking about the seven values of leadership, is that every situation is going to demand something different from you. I just happen to deal with the same situation with two different variables, two major variables that are still leading to lack of results. And so I want to talk about the store that I'm helping right now. And they have a great team, full of energy, very positive. But at the end of the day, the team is not getting results. They're not executing on a specific goal that the company has for them and for us for that matter. And I've come to realize as I spent time with them what's happening. And so I want to share this with you guys. So let me share my observations. And when you think about how to be successful, you have to be objective. You have to be able to step back and say, okay, what is the root cause? And I will tell you, with the first store, what I've realized is, you know, even though the team is positive and even though that they have great associates and a strong leadership team, they're missing one major dynamic, and that's being team orientated. So I've come to realize that although they're trying really hard, they are not operating in unison. They are not communicating to each other. They are not focusing on, hey, as a team, this is how we're going to move the boulder together. Hey, we need to look at schedules to see how there's a disconnect. We need to look at the team's motivation behind that. We need to look at how each leader can contribute and what's needed and what's expected from them. And at this point, that hasn't been given to them. At this point, they're kind of working hard, but they're working in completely different directions, which is not allowing them to harness the leadership to push the boulder. And you know, I sat down with them and we you know, I showed them some inspirational videos and things like that to kind of get the juice flowing, that as a group we have decided that the problem is not us, that the problem is, you know, everyone else outside of the building, or it's their circumstance and, you know, all that stuff. But they never looked into the mirror to say, hey, you know what, as a leader, I am not contributing to my full potential. And then we had a great conversation that each one of them clearly owned that they were not contributing. And that's the hard thing about leadership, guys, is that sometimes we got to have the tough conversations. And I asked them, are you telling me right now that you are giving everything that you have, that you are relentlessly trying to find a solution, or have you already given up? And one by one, they all admitted the truth. They were not giving their all because it was almost pointless, because they've been trying for the last year and they've been struggling continuously and never able to deliver this specific result or this metric. And I said, you know, I understand that, but you know what? My store went through the same thing. We were in the same exact situation. And I told them, I love stuff like this because this is going to challenge your will set. This is going to challenge you to say, I'm going to push myself. I'm going to feel uncomfortable, and it's okay to feel uncomfortable, but I'm going to, you know, leave this building every day exhausted because I gave it everything that I had inside. And we'll start to build momentum. We'll start to build things. And you know, surprisingly enough, everyone's like was fired up. Everyone was excited. They were very energized about it. And guess what happened? Within 48 hours, the metric starts to move in a way that they've never seen before, right? And then 2 days later, they do it again. And then we kind of stumbled and went back. But you know what? They did something that they have never done before. And they tasted success. And now when I double back to talk with them, it's, you know, the excitement has grown because now they believe that they're capable, and they self-discovered their ability to execute. Now we still have challenges because everyone's got to be in unison, and there were some bad days and then we have good days and go back. But at the core, they're starting to believe. They're starting to believe that their will set can make anything happen. And that was amazing because it kind of reminded me, it humbled me back down to remember what it felt like to be a failure, what it felt like when you're not successful and people are on top of you constantly challenging you because you're not delivering. And will set was at the core of it for that building. And I want to share another situation that happened, but this time it was in my building. You know, as I'm juggling both these stores, it's tough. It's a tough thing to do, to manage multiple stores. But you know what? I had the same situation with one of my leaders, except they're in an environment that I've helped build, that we facilitate growth and development and nurturing and encouragement. And this store and this team has been successful historically, just, you know, making things happen. And I'm so proud of them. But yet one leader continued to struggle, even with a positive environment, even with leadership team that's actually nurturing them, she continued to struggle. So you ask yourself, okay, you have one environment that maybe the support wasn't there, that's understandable, but now you're in an environment that is actually supporting you, and yet the execution is still not there. And this was a completely different situation. And instead of looking to use the same approach, I wanted to find out the truth. I wanted to find out what's going on with this leader. And you know, it came back down to will set. And you know, and I had to ask a lot of hard questions like, are you happy? How do you feel? Are you confident in your ability to execute? You know, do you feel supported? So I asked all those fundamental questions and they were all, yes, I feel supported. Everyone's here to help me. And I said, so why after a few months of you being here, have you continued to struggle with this? And, you know, we got down to the core. We had a very, very honest conversation that, you know, it wasn't about accountability. It was about, tell me what's happening right now. You know, and we came to the discovery that there's a lot of stuff going on outside, which we all have things like that. But it came down to will set. Like, do you want to do this? And if you don't want to do it, then I'm okay with that. You know, you have opportunities to, you know, continue on with your career somewhere else if that's what you want to do. But when you're here, I need your commitment. I need you to figure out what happened to your will set because you don't believe in yourself anymore. You don't believe that you can take, you know, make these things happen like we used to. That changed from you, not from the environment. So that came from within. And as we talked about things and we discussed things, she started to self-discover what the root cause was. And the root cause was not knowing if this is what they want to do. And that's okay because we can talk about that. We can discuss that. And at the end of the conversation, she was back on track. back on track. They're like, hey, we're going to challenge you. We need you right now. I need you to step up. I need you to deliver results. But I can't keep managing you in the way that I am right now. I can't keep spending my time doing all this follow-up because now I expect things from you. And I'm going to challenge you to get there, but I can't micromanage you. Otherwise, you're never going to be successful. And so when you look at these two situations, two different scenarios that we had to look at different things. You know, one of them was being team orientated in that first store, just working together, being tough to work together. And then the other one is accountability. So they had two different values that I had to focus on with these stores, even though they were doing the same thing. They were both having issues with execution. Each one of them needed something different. That's why it's so important for us to understand the seven values of leadership and understand that every team may have two strengths, two values that they naturally do well, and then they may have two values that they don't. When we understand how those values impact their performance, then we're going to take a closer look at what we can do to impact them, how we can guide them through those specific values. So this is why it's so important that we understand what it takes to be successful. But at the core of it, guys, there has to be the will to change. And that is the most powerful tool that you're going to have to get from your team. And it's commitment, not only to the team, but to themselves. And sometimes we have to facilitate that because they don't know. They've never been exposed to that level of leadership where their will set is being challenged, that their leadership is being challenged. And that's why you are the most critical piece to it, is because you're going to have to facilitate that. So I hope sharing these two situations gives you a kind of context around how the seven values of leadership work and how you can use them with your team in the real world. And I'm still in the field, so I'm living this stuff right now. It took me a moment to step back and analyze what's happening in these two stores and how am I going to approach them differently to what their needs are. So I want you guys to think about your teams and think about the challenges that you've had and think about different environments that you've been in where they've called on different needs of your leadership. But I'm going to tell you, changing a culture takes willpower, and you are going to be the key to it. So I want to leave you with this final note. Sometimes we have to dig deep. Sometimes it's going to be uncomfortable. Sometimes we're going to feel lost. And sometimes we're going to feel like nobody cares. At the core of it, your will set has to change. You have to do what's right for you. Don't worry about results. Don't worry about things. Just worry about that you're going to give it everything you have inside. And from that point on, you'll start to chip away at whatever you're struggling with, and you'll find solutions. Stay solution oriented. Keep the team positive and do whatever it takes. Find out what's holding your teams back. Find out why their motivation has deteriorated and get them fired up. That's what you got to do. That's your role. Get them fired up. Get them motivated. Get them moving in the right direction. And I know that you're going to be able to execute anything that gets put in front of you with the simple use of will set.
Stay tuned for the next podcast. Always remember, awaken the leader inside.